Many genes in eukaryotes have sequences that interrupt the coding of amino acids in the protein product. These sequences are introns and they are spliced out of the mRNA. The coding sequences that remain in the mRNA are exons and they specify the amino acids in the protein. The transcription of these genes produces a pre-mRNA molecule, which is an exact copy of the gene with both exons and introns. To make a mature mRNA, the pre-mRNA has to remove the introns and join the exons together. This is called the RNA splicing. RNA splicing relies on finding the border between exon and intron. Introns usually start with 5' GU and end with 3' AG. But other bases at both the 5' and 3' splice sites also help to define the exon-intron boundaries. RNA splicing involves several steps that use small nuclear ribonucleoprotein particles, or snRNPs. snRNPs are made of small RNA molecules and some proteins. The first step in splicing is when the U1 snRNP binds to the 5' splice site between exon 1 and intron 1. U1 attaches to the GU at the 5' end of the intron. If a mutation changes one of these bases, splicing at this site is blocked and the intron stays in the mRNA. Besides the 5' GU and 3' AG intron sequences, there is also the branch point sequence that is important for RNA splicing. The branch point sequence has 7 bases near the 3' AG splice site. In mammals, the sequence is YNCURAY, where Y is a pyrimidin, N is any base, and R is a purine. U1 binding at the 5' GU leads to the attachment of the U2 snRNP. The U2 binds to the last adenine of the branch point sequence. A trimer forms between the U4, U5 and U6 snRNPs. These trimer associates with both U1 and U2, bringing them closer. This makes the intron loop. After U1 and U2 are brought together, U4 is released. This release results in the formation of an active spliceosome, which removes the intron from between the two adjacent exons. Cleavage first occurs at the 5' GU, separating intron 1 from exon 1. The 5' guanine forms a covalent bond with the last adenine in the branch point sequence. This loop structure is a lariat. Cleavage then occurs at the junction between 3' AG and exon 2. Exon 1 and exon 2 are joined together in a 5'-3' phosphodiester bond and the intron is released. U1, U2, U5 and U6 stay attached to the intron lariat and carry it to debranching enzymes in the nucleus. The enzymes break down the RNA and recycle the bases. This process is repeated for each intron. When all introns have been removed, a mature mRNA is made. Now the mRNA can leave the nucleus and be translated by ribosomes in the cytoplasm.